Here we are with Windows 10. This is the installation routine. I'm going to show you how we do this with VMware so you don't overwrite your main operating system on your computer. You can get VMware from VMware's website and a 30-day trial is available. So all we need to do is point VMware to the ISO and obviously get everything set up. Essentially what's going to happen here is we're going to set up the various features for VMware. For instance, we're setting how much disk space it's going to use. And then we're just going to go in and we're going to add a bit more memory and a couple more processors just to make sure that it's not going to take too long to do. Now, all of this depends on your particular computer's specs. Do make sure you don't overload any of your resources here. Make sure you have your correct number of cores set, etc., or your system will lag out quite badly. Hit start, and now it will start running through the installation procedure. I have to say, everything is very Windows 8 at the moment. The installation routine is literally just the same one we've had from Windows 7 and Windows 8. The odd little tart up and tweak here or there once you actually get into the setup utility just before the Windows desktop, but everything else very much the muchness. You'll need to accept the terms and conditions and decide how you're going to set everything up. Use custom, create a new partition, and make sure you format the larger partition as well. Windows should take care of the other one for you. Don't do as I do here and format the wrong partition, because it just wastes time, basically. Now, I have shortened a lot of the sequences here other than the key steps because who actually wants to sit looking at the Windows installation screen with a gear spinning for the better part of 10 minutes? Pretty boring. Now, the installation takes around about 15 to 20 minutes installing onto just a single hard drive, a traditional old style hard drive with a reasonably beefy PC behind it. A lot of the time is spent unpacking and deflating all of the files that they've got here. Once more of the installation has run through, it will then finish up and you'll restart the virtual machine. You can let it do it automatically or, of course, press the button. Windows does have to spend a fair amount of time installing itself to the drive, setting everything up and so on. So like I say, can take around 10 to 15 minutes for this process to run through. Now incidentally, the actual download took around about half an hour to an hour to actually download on our reasonably fast internet connection. Unfortunately, it seems Microsoft are limiting the amount of bandwidth they're giving away at the moment. Now, once that main installation has run through, we'll then find ourselves at the new Windows setup. Now, this is very familiar to Windows 8, 8.1. Few tweaks and changes and a few more options, I think, here than we may have had previously. It's been a fair old while since I've done a vanilla install of Windows, but in part, you're going to have to sign into your Microsoft account and also enter a special code that they send you. This is very similar to Windows 8. You can then import your settings from another machine if it's already logged onto your account and set up. Now, this next process, again, does seem to take a while. It may very well be downloading some apps and updates in the background for the Windows Store, but it sits there and it does spend another 5 minutes or so just running through whatever it happens to be doing at this time, but at least it looks quite pretty while it's doing it. When you see Let's Start, you're done. Here is the Windows 10 desktop. What we do need to do now is, because we're using a VMware session, let's install the VMware tools. Quick and easy, all you need to do is select it from the tab up the top on the menu and then visit the CD drive that has been virtually created inside the VMware session. Run the setup utility, make sure you choose the correct version of the setup. If you have x32, you just want setup. If you have x64, choose the 64 option. Don't install the wrong one or things will go badly wrong for you. Now what we're really looking for here is the graphics driver. As soon as you see that installed, you can then go into the screen resolution option and set the resolution correctly. 1080p if you've got a 1080p monitor and so on. Once we've done that, we have Windows 10 and we can full screen it and it looks gorgeous and it's being accelerated. Thanks for watching. Do please subscribe to us on YouTube and Twitch, and please like and comment on these videos as well. We love to chat.